ask the question that how can you convince to a non-Muslim why fortune telling is bad? Point number one. As far as Allah says in the Quran in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 90, Ya ayyuhal lazina amun, O you believe, innamal khamru al maisuru, most certainly intoxication and gambling, wal anzabu al azlamu, dedication of stones, divination of arrows, rishthum minam ili shaitan, these are Satan's handiwork. Fashtanibu lalakum tuflihun, abstain from the handiwork that may prosper. So here it is a guidance given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that alcohol, intoxicants, gambling, idol worship, and fortune telling is haram. Divination of arrows is haram. Allah says, we agree with it. Logically, if we have to prove, what we have to say, point number one, most of the people who predict the future, talking about astrology, or looking at the stars, or looking at, 99% of them are fake. And that were the strategies. Majority, almost all you can say. They predict so many things will happen, you'll have so many children, etc. And most of them have a particular strategy. You go on the street, there's a parrot picking up a card for you and that becomes the feature. You go to a machine, put a dead bird, something happens. Now there's a common strategy used. For example, if you go and talk to a machine which says, put $1 or put so many rupees and talks about a future, you put a date of birth. Then it says that something bad is going to happen in the next week. Even if 100 good things happen, one bad thing will happen. Ha, say Nikla. Next person will say, something good will happen in the next 1 week. So even if 100 bad things happen, one good will happen or something. So these are statements which are general, which it does happen. And there was a survey done in USA that one of the psychologists, he took a class of the students and he talked to them for a month. And at the end of the month, he told them that I will write about your past to every student. 100 students are there. And he said, don't open a chit. To every student, I'll write what happened in your past because I stayed with you for 1 month. Now I know about your background history, everything. So he wrote to every student, individual student, about his past. He said, okay, now keep the chit closed, open, and give me marks. How accurate have I been? So when all the students opened the chits, and more than 95% told that the teacher was 98% accurate. 5% said that he was above 90%. Everyone opened the chit, great. He spoke about my past. 95% said he's 98% accurate. Some said 99. 5% said he's 90, 91, 92%. But everyone said above 90%. The joke was, he wrote the same thing for all 100 people. You understand, no? So how you formulate and how well are you able to fool? So most of this is just false. And even if someone can predict, suppose, everything, the baki 99% are not right. My 1% is the main guru. He fails to 99%, he's also a fraud. But even if, suppose, that thing is there, Quran says that you should not be bothered about it. This is a test for the hereafter. For example, this is the life you're ready for test for the hereafter. For example, there's examination going. First, you have to convince him that this is a fraud. That's the main answer. Second answer is that this is a test for the hereafter. We're undergoing a test according to Islam follow. Then you're talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Mulk, chapter number 6 and verse number 2, Allazi khalaqal mawta wal hayata. It is Allah who has created death and life to test which of you. This is a big answer, no? The second part to convince that 1%. That is the test for the hereafter. And when we're undergoing an examination, you have to follow the rules and regulation of the examination. The examination, haram, haram. Say, why haram? For example, in examination, the teacher says, copying is haram. Leaking of the question sheet is haram. But why haram? If it leaks, I get 100 out of 100. Correct? But you as a good parent, will you tell your son, okay, wahan milta hai 50 rupees mein paper. You can get the paper. Maybe a bad parent will say, jaan dena kya haram hai. Tere bachche ko to medicine sheet milengi. Milengi, lekin wo maarenga bachche ko. Medicine will get a seat. When he passes, he'll kill the people rather than cure them. You understand, na? So here, if you get the question sheet, it's not going to benefit. Allah knows that. That doesn't mean no one can. A few people can. The percentage may be 0.1, whatever it is. Not that they cannot predict. But prediction is wrong for you for your future. It's going to harm you more than cause you good. So even if you get a question paper of the 10th standard exam, or 12th standard exam, or an MBBS exam, you may think for short term, he'll get a gold medal. But finally, when he sits to treat the patient, he will not cure them, he will kill them. So, those people who honestly will say yes, getting the question paper in advance is wrong. But yet some people will be cheaters who will say, jaan dena. So, Allah knows best that knowing your future will cause you more harm in the akhirah. So, in the real test, this examination you sit at the end of the year. It's trying to judge how good you are. So, there if you cheat in the long run, you will not be successful. Hope that answers the question.